The most remarkable thing about your presidency was that you took, not only took the job, you made it your own, but you redefined for most Indians what the president of India was doing. You know, could you share with us some of the, you were able, in my opinion, for those 5 years to deliver more value, inspiration to this country than our current system of governance is able to deliver to its citizens.
See, as soon as 25th July 2002, I entered Rashtrapati Bhavan. My staff thought this fellow doesn't know the constitution. They kept a constitution book there. Okay, that was media also telling. This fellow who comes to occupy this place, constitution is a problem for him. So, one thing I found, sincerely I read constitution, I want to tell you that, from first page to last page I read constitution. Then I found the president's power, sky is the limit. President powers, for example, it doesn't prohibit, I am talking about India 2020 vision, it doesn't prohibit, okay? And India 2020, when I talk to the people, they enjoy it. And particularly students, they get ignited, their mind is ignited in a big way. So one thing I found, the present fellow, lady, has got a unique responsibility. Anything I ask as a president from any part of the country, I will get it immediately. Nobody else can get it. I will give a present, 15 assemblies I have addressed. And all the assembly I got from the same bureaucrats who immediately they will give me the data. So I felt first and foremost is I realized president can do bigger things. That is what people forget. That is put them in the vision and how to do it. So that period when I was a professor, when Vajpayee said, you guy become a president, then I said, at that time India 2020, that is roadmap was ready. This is the time I should go and market in your terms. I can go market India 2020 vision. I did it. I talked in parliament, I took the cabinet, and to some extent I sold it also, okay? So answer to your question, one thing I realized, the president has got unlimited power to interact with people. He doesn't prohibit. I was everywhere. I was every part of the state where people don't go. So he can have a direct connection, president, he or she can have a direct connection with the people. This I realized when it's going on, and I enjoyed a lot of gardens we had, and nearly once in a year, 1 billion people visited. So it becomes people's bhavan, Rashtrapati Bhavan, it becomes a people's bhavan. And you can do vision, you can communicate to the people vision. That I had a studio, I could anytime reach my people, anytime reach the universities, mm-hmm. 3 universities, 4 you can connect and give a address. So I felt that's a position which is, it is not properly understood by the media and the various type of people. He or she has got a tremendous accountability and the power, I call it latent power, okay? Yes. Did I answer you?
You did, but I'll ask a follow-on question. Yes. So,
you are the chairman?
We're all chairman.
But, you know, the reading of the Constitution sort of brought out the fact to you that this is the position with unlimited power, latent power. But I think that everybody sitting in this room in a certain sense has that unlimited and latent power. Is there something that you would like to share with how to realize that? Because I think what you're seeing today in this country is a desire for change, not the small incremental, two steps forward, one step backward sort of change that we are seeing, but something that is more 5 steps forward and maybe 1 step backward. Sort of.
See, I don't want to give a big answer for that. I have got a God, a 10 Rajaji Mark, no? 10 Rajaji Mark. They gave me 10 Rajaji Mark house. They have got a lawn there. The government of India, they give me one garden to me. It's a big garden. One garden. But the garden always beautiful. I was asking myself, how one chap he can keep the whole garden happy, blossoming. Only one fellow. I'm asking 10 fellows, 15 fellows, but I got one. One day, I started becoming a friend of, his name is Kanjan. I became his friend. So because I walk 1 hour, I always see him. He gives some fruits every day. He plucks from the Chinese trees and gives me, I eat it. Very stubborn, don't eat it, but I eat it. That's habit I got from Rashtrapati Bhavan. But you know, one, how he is happy with him, his work, even though he is not a very paid officer, paid man. If a flower blossoms, he is the happiest man. He will take me, a flower has blossomed. You know? That, you know, the happiness if you draw from the performance what you do, it will be a fantastic. For example, I will give an incident. This is all of you who have assembled here, all of you. Remember this incident. 1979. SLV-3, satellite launch vehicle. I was the project director, mission director. My mission is to put the satellite in the orbit. Thousands of people worked nearly 10 years. I reached the Sriharikota. And it's in the launch pad. Countdown was going on. T-minus 4 minutes, T-minus 5 minutes, T-minus 1 minute, T-minus 40 seconds. Computer put a hold. Don't launch it. Computer says, don't launch it. I am the mission director. I have to take decision. Everything is on. Behind me, there are 6 experts. They saw data, computer database coming in and screen, and they see the pictures in the screen, they said there's a problem. The problem is there's a leakage in the system, in the control system. But immediate calculation, no problem. We have got sufficient fuel and oxidize for control system is control the rocket to the required attitude. And we can go ahead. Now, of course, my expert's view, but I took the decision. Problem is mine. I took a decision. I bypassed the computer, I launched the system. Okay, I launched the system. This fellow went. First stage worked with a 4-stage rocket, and second stage got mad. It went to the spin. Instead of putting the satellite in the orbit, it put in the Bay of Bengal. 1979, it was a failure. It was a failure. First time I experienced my failure. How do you manage the failure? Success I can manage. So at that time, a great man, a great leader, Professor Satish Dhawan, he comes to me, I'm very tired working nearly for months. He wakes me up, come, let us go for a press conference. Press is meeting there, like this, number of people, world press, with photo, this and that, all the gadget, they are there. I was really frightened, I will be the culprit, because I'm the project director, mission director. What Satish Dhawan said, chairman, Indian Space Research Organization, said, dear friends, we have failed today. It's the first time I have to give all the success, all the failure. I want to support my technologists and scientists and staff so that next year they succeed. So he took the whole blame himself. And then media asked, you put Bay of Bengal, so many crores, you have put it. Like that, lot of criticism. He received the criticism. He assured them, in a year we will succeed with our team. It's a very good team. Next year, here only interesting thing happened. Next year, July 18th, 1980, when he succeeded, Professor Dhawan said, you go and conduct the press conference. Do you follow what this means? It means when the failure occurred, the leader took it up. When the success came, he gives to his team. That's the first. So, answer to question, this is what I learned. Fantastic. That is how to manage the failure, 1980, I learned it stands always. Similarly, the flower blossoming, a person, he gets all the enjoyment of a flower blossoming Kanjan. These two incidents always cheers me up.